time, exact weather meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on to your tropical weather update. Let's head out to the tropics. We'll start off in the Atlantic Basin. Bertha finally became a Category 1 hurricane. As you can see, she's looking kind of organized. She has strengthened, though. The National Hurricane Center has concluded that Bertha is now a Category 1 hurricane with maximum sustained winds of 80 miles per hour. The good news is Bertha is going to stay away from the continental United States, but as we look at the daylight picture, really tough to pick out the center of circulation. It's somewhere generally in around this area. Still not getting that wraparound intense thunderstorm activity, but getting just enough intense thunderstorm activity to have Bertha strengthen and intensify. Still getting a little bit of shear, but not a whole lot. Shear, of course, are those strong upper-level winds that have a tendency of pulling a storm apart. So Bertha held herself together, crossing Hispaniola over the weekend. Now a Category 1 hurricane with winds of 80 miles per hour, moving to the north at 17 miles per hour. The millibar pressure now down to 998 as we put the official track from the Hurricane Center in motion. Looks like Bertha will maintain that Category 1 status and start making that right-hand turn away from the continental United States by Tuesday, or rather Wednesday morning. Notice winds dropped about 70 miles per hour. That'll make Bertha a rather strong tropical storm, but going to come kind of close to Newfoundland right here as a extra tropical low pressure system. So that'll probably cause a few problems for St. John's and Newfoundland, and then stays out in the North Atlantic as an area of low pressure. And since we're talking about the tropics, something interesting to report out in the eastern Pacific, rather active. A couple of storms brewing out there. This tropical storm Julio, and we've got Category 4 Hurricane Isel. Isel is going to be traveling to the west, and watch as we transition over into the national hurricane tracks here. 140 mile per hour winds for Isel. Julio right now has wind speeds of 45 miles per hour. If we go out a couple of days here, look what happens. This, of course, Hawaii. 70 mile per hour winds by Thursday morning. Looks like Isel is going to cross over Hawaii with wind speeds between 60 and 70 miles per hour on a downward trend as Isel crosses the Hawaiian Islands. But nonetheless, at 60 miles per hour, that is going to be causing some problems for the people over there in Hawaii. Lots of rainfall, probably some mudslides. Meanwhile, Tropical Storm Julio, I know it's tough to make out the tracks, but that's going to be right here, Category 1. Looks like Julio will stay south of the Hawaiian Islands as it stands right now, but Julio will definitely be worth watching because two hits from a tropical system, that would not be good for Hawaii. So hopefully Julio will stay to the south, but definitely looks like the Hawaiian Islands are going to take almost a direct hit from at least a tropical storm, which will be Isel, over the next 3 to 5 days. That's the latest from the tropics. Thanks for logging on. I'm exact weather meteorologist Jay Galley.